Hello, this is your daily dose of news from On Manorama. I am your host Vishnu and these are the major news stories of Monday, February 19th, 2024. Tribal violence in Papua New Guinea killed at least 26 combatants and an unconfirmed number of bystanders. The World Court on Monday opened a week of hearings on the legal consequences of Israel's occupation of Palestinian territories. Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal skipped the Enforcement Directorate summons for the sixth time in the money laundering case linked to the excise policy and asked the agency to wait for the court order before issuing a fresh notice. The Kerala High Court upheld the punishment awarded to the convicts in the T.P. Chandrasekharan murder case by a lower court and also nullified the acquittal of two accused. As mercury soars in Kerala, the Indian Meteorological Department issued a high temperature warning for six districts. Let's get into the details. At least 26 combatants and an unconfirmed number of bystanders were killed in a gun battle between warring tribes in Papua New Guinea, police said on Monday. A tribe, their allies and mercenaries were on their way to attack a neighboring tribe when they were ambushed on Sunday in Enga province in the South Pacific nation's remote highlands, Royal Papua New Guinea Constabulary Acting Superintendent George Carcass said. Police Commissioner David Manning later described the clash as a gun battle between warring tribes. An unconfirmed number of villagers also were killed. Tribal violence in the Enga region has intensified since elections in 2022 that maintained Prime Minister James Marape's administration. Elections and accompanying allegations of cheating and process anomalies have always triggered violence throughout the country. Australian Prime Minister Anthony Albanese said his government was ready to assist Papua New Guinea, which is Australia's nearest neighbour and the largest single recipient of Australian foreign aid. Papua New Guinea is a diverse nation of 10 million mostly subsistence farmers speaking 800 languages. Internal security has become an increasing challenge for its government as China, the United States, and Australia seek closer security ties to the country in a strategically important part of the South Pacific. The United Nations top court on Monday opened a week of hearings on the legal consequences of Israel's occupation of Palestinian territories, with more than 50 states due to address the judges. Palestinian Foreign Minister Riyad al-Maliki spoke first in the legal proceedings at the International Court of Justice in The Hague. In 2022, the UN General Assembly asked the court for an advisory or non-binding opinion on the occupation. The hearings will be held until February 26th. After that, the judges are expected to take several months to deliberate before issuing an advisory opinion. While Israel has ignored such opinions in the past, it could increase political pressure over its ongoing war in Gaza, which has killed about 29,000 Palestinians according to Gaza health officials since October 7th. Among countries scheduled to participate in the hearings are the United States, Israel's strongest supporter, China, Russia, South Africa, and Egypt. Israel will not participate, although it has sent written observations. The hearings are part of a Palestinian push to get international legal institutions to examine Israel's conduct, which has become more urgent since the October 7 attacks by Hamas in Israel, which killed 1,200 people, and Israel's military response. They also come amid mounting concerns about an Israeli ground offensive against the Gaza city of Rafah, a last refuge for more than a million Palestinians after they fled to the south of the enclave to avoid Israeli assaults. Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal did not appear before the Enforcement Directorate on Monday for questioning in a money laundering case linked to the excise policy matter, with his party terming the summons as illegal. The Aam Aadmi Party said the Enforcement Directorate should wait for the court's decision instead of repeatedly sending summonses to Kejriwal. Kejriwal has been summoned six times by the ED. The agency had earlier this month approached a city court after Kejriwal skipped its multiple summonses related to the case. Kejriwal told reporters at the Delhi Assembly that the reply to the ED were being given as per the law. The Aam Aadmi Party leadership, including Kejriwal, has been alleging that the BJP wanted to arrest him to topple his government in Delhi and finish the party. It is alleged that the Delhi government's excise policy for 2021-2022 to grant licenses to liquor traders allowed cartelization and favoured certain dealers who had allegedly paid bribes for it, a charge repeatedly refuted by the Aam Aadmi Party. The policy was scrapped after Delhi Lieutenant Governor V.K. Saxena in July 2022 recommended a CBI probe into alleged irregularities and lapses in its implementation. After the CBI, the ED also registered a case under the Prevention of Money Laundering Act in the matter. In a setback to the convicts of Revolutionary Marxist Party leader T.P. Chandrasekharan murder case, the Kerala High Court on Monday dismissed their appeal while upholding the quantum of punishment awarded by a lower court. The court also nullified the acquittal of two accused, including CPM leader K.K. Krishnan and Jyothi Babu. The court asked the duo to appear before the court on February 26th and face trial in the case. Meanwhile, the court upheld the order acquitting Kozhikode CPM District Secretary P. Mohanan, who was booked for conspiracy charges. An additional sessions court in Kozhikode awarded life term for 11 convicts in the murder case. In its crucial judgment, the High Court has upheld this 2014 order of the lower court. Chandrasekharan's wife K.K. Rama welcomed the verdict and declared that she would continue the fight until all people, including P. Mohanan, get convicted in the case. T.P. Chandrasekharan, the founder of the Revolutionary Marxist Party, was hacked to death by a gang around 10 p.m. on May 4, 2012. He was returning home on his bike when the gang knocked him down with their car before brutally hacking him. The then UDF government constituted a special investigation team which arrested 76 people in the case. The additional sessions court in Kozhikode sentenced 11 to life imprisonment and awarded 3 years jail term to another person on January 22, 2014. Kerala will continue to experience hot and humid conditions as the mercury levels are expected to surge in the coming days. The India Meteorological Department sounded a yellow alert for 6 districts, Ernakulam, Thrissur, Kannur, Alappuzha, Kottayam and Kozhikode, as a caution against high temperature. As per the alert, Ernakulam, Thrissur and Kannur will record a maximum temperature of 37 degrees Celsius on Monday and Tuesday. Meanwhile, the mercury level may touch a maximum 36 degrees Celsius in Alappuzha, Kottayam and Kozhikode districts on the same days. The Met Department has predicted a rise of 2 to 4 degrees Celsius in the normal temperature in these three districts. With the IMD alerting against high temperature, the Kerala Disaster Management Authority issued an advisory instructing people to take necessary precautions to avoid sunstroke and dehydration. That brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening to Daily News Dose, hosted and produced by me, Vishnu Muralidharan, with technical support from IW Studios. Follow www.onmanorama.com for detailed updates on the latest news and be sure to come back tomorrow.